welcome everybody, and I really appreciate everybody coming out and just coming out. This is a really nice crowd, I think. It shows community interest, and I think it's these important issues, it's important that we get together and talk about these things. The Dallas Wells County Chamber of Commerce Government Affairs Council, this is the Transportation Policy Committee of that council, consists of Brett McLean, Brad Iyer, who is on his way, Dallas City Council, and Sandra Tooley, who is out there somewhere, Airport Manager Jim Galloway, and Reese Atkins here. And I want to thank my committee members here. This will be our last meeting of the year for the work that y'all put in so far this year, and I think we've accomplished a lot. I think we've got a lot on the table and a lot going on. We've had a lot of help from other people as well, and I'd like to recognize some of them now. First and foremost, as far as transportation issues are concerned, would be Tim Golden, our representative on the Georgia Department of Transportation Commission. Mayor John Gale, County Commission Chairman Bill Slaughter, Pat Collins, City Engineer. I know I'm going to miss somebody, so I'm going to stop while I'm ahead. And Corey Hall, and of course, J.D. Allen. thanks for all everything that y'all have done to help us and the community in bringing about everything that we need. And of course, the City Council and Tim.
There you go.
Dean, I'm so glad you were here to point that out. I appreciate that a lot. It's often said that knowledge is power, and the phrase is commonly attributed to Sir Francis Bacon, and it goes back as far as 1597, a treatise he wrote, Sacred Meditations. And it's true. The more we know about a concept or position or project, the better informed we are. And the better informed we are, our decisions regarding any particular issue can be better informed, better grounded in fact, and in application. Now, while we're not likely to do much meditating this afternoon, whether it be sacred or otherwise, we can and will listen to points of view on a variety of transportation issues that affect our community under current consideration on both the local and state levels. Now, to ensure a more efficient use of our time, and I'm a proponent that good doses make good neighbors, and to make sure our time together is efficient and productive, and that everyone has an opportunity to comment that wants to comment, we've got a few little simple rules. As a general rule, this is a Chamber of Commerce event. To address this committee, you should be a member of the Chamber of Commerce. If you come up on the podium here, we ask you to do that. State your name. Please speak clearly enough and with enough volume to be heard. There's no mic here, and we really don't need one. And some of us, well, at least speaking for myself, don't hear like we used to. Please be concise and limit your comments to 3 minutes. We will time it. Now, a committee member may ask a question, or you may get asked a question, and respond to that question as concisely as you can. If someone covers the same point you want to see covered, or if someone expresses the same opinion you wish to express, you may want to consider not doing a double take on it, so that we won't burn up time that we don't need to burn up. We don't want to have to turn on oil lamps later on in the season. So we want to wrap this thing up in a reasonable amount of time. I like to shoot for an hour, but we'll see how it goes. Now, with all that in mind, we'll start out with comments for those interested in the downtown truck mitigation project. I'm not going to go back to the dinosaurs on this, except to say that trucks downtown are a problem, have been for years. But also has tried over the years to get GDOT, anybody, some help, whatever. We finally got together on the truck mitigation study last year. Summer, worked on it throughout the fall, and with the help of especially of Tim Golden, we were able to get the attention of Commissioner McMurray, who says it's just time. So the idea, there should be a map behind me, and there may be some foldouts there. The most common, the truck mitigation study gave several variations. Many of them cut Valdosta in half and in two and stuff like that. We proposed a really southernmost bypass, which is illustrated, I believe, in that purple line. That will take take the trucks off at 84 Perimeter Road, swing them through the industrial park, generally speaking, then pull them over the interstate, hook them back in at 84 somewhere around the James Road. That's the general idea. It's not in stone at all, but that's the general idea. It cuts down the number of traffic lights for the trucks. It allows them to go faster. It doesn't cut through our South Valdosta neighborhoods. It gets the trucks to where they need to be in the industrial park. GDOT likes it. They'll fine-tune it. They'll figure out what can be done and what can't be done. But anyway, that's what that is, and it's very much a working project. We met with the commissioner February 1st, and this is some committees being studied right now, so we're making some great strides with this. Now, would anyone like to address the issue of downtown truck mitigation? I explained it so well.